Dear viewers, Assalamu alaikum. May Allah's peace, mercy, blessings be upon you. Welcome to Gems from the Quran. Alhamdulillah, today we are in a new chapter, but we already spoke about this chapter in the previous and before that even, in two episodes. And we only spoke about the virtues, the reward that Allah Almighty giving us by only reading this chapter, by only loving this chapter, what Allah Almighty will give us. And we spoke about it in two separate episodes before that. And today, insha'Allah ta'ala, we will enter to this chapter, the chapter of sincerity, Surah Al-Ikhlas. And as I mentioned, it is Makki Surah. It is a Makki Surah. Allah Almighty revealed it before the Hijrah, before the migration of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Quickly, I would like to refresh your information that Allah Almighty sent down this chapter because some of the non-believers and the idol worshipper came to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and they said, "Who is your Lord? Describe us your Lord. Who is your Allah? Describe your Allah." So Allah Almighty sent down these verses. So what Allah Almighty said, we will start by saying, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful. And then Allah Almighty said, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. Say, O Muhammad, هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. He is Allah, the one only. Only the one. He does not have any partner. He does not have any association. He does not have any sons or kids or family. Nothing. He is Allah, the one only. This is very serious for all of us. This is very important for all of us that we have to know Allah, the one God that we worship, He is one without any partner. No son, no daughter, no wife, nothing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who deserves to be worshipped. So, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. قُلْ, Muhammad, say to them, Allah is one. Not only that, Allah is one means that we have to put all our efforts and our worship and everything, and we only and only dedicate everything to Him in order to get the acceptance from Allah Almighty. You know why Allah Almighty, He preferred to call Himself Allah? Allah, people will call it God. But the literally, Allah means the one God. And He preferred Himself to call Allah rather than calling Himself God. There is no problem to other people for them to understand who is Allah. We can say God, who is above the heaven, who is the one. We have to explain that. But Allah by itself is the one God. So for example, if I come to a Hindu and if I tell him God, for him he will think about a cow or a fire or a rat or anything that he worships, or a tree, or a fire, or anything. So for him, if I tell him God, he will think about a cow. He will think about a fire. He will think about the tree. But for me, if I say Allah, He is the one only. If I go to a Christian and I will tell him God, the word God will make him to think about Jesus, or about the God the Father, or about the Holy Spirit. No, but I mean the God, the one only, above the heaven, without any partners. If you go to someone else, and if you go to the Buddhist, and you tell him about the God, he will think in his mind about the Buddha, right? But I mean Allah means one God. That's why Allah Almighty call Himself Huwa Allah. In other verse, Huwa Allahu alladhi la ilaha illa huwa. He is Allah, the one only. There is no other than Him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the meaning of Allah. We have to understand the word of Allah. It's not only the God. Allah means the only one God who deserves to be worshipped. Imagine, this is only one verse from the Quran as I am reciting, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. Say, O Muhammad, to people and to everyone in today's time, Allah is the one. and we should worship him. So whenever you are praying now, and whenever you are reading the Quran next time, when you say قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, you should understand that he is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above the heaven, and he is the one who deserves to be worshipped. We will continue insha'Allah ta'ala after the break with the upcoming verses, so stay with us insha'Allah ta'ala. Dear viewers, welcome back. So, we explained before the break about قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. Say, he is Allah, the one only. And then Allah Almighty said about himself, اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ. Allah, the eternal. And صَمَد has lots of other meaning, but in English, only the one word can fit. So the translator, he put eternal, right? But samad means الَّذِي يَصْمُدُ إِلَيْهَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ إِلَيْهِ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ, means that everything is depending on him. He is the dependent. He is not independent. He is completely, everything is depending on him. He is independent. He is independent, Allah Almighty. And nothing can take any action back and forward except by his permission. This is what as-samad means. That the word coming also from sumud, the one who is standing without any need, the one who is standing without any rest. He does not require any rest. He does not require any food. He does not require to drink. He does not require to sleep. As Allah Almighty said in the other verse, لَا تَأْخُدُهُ سِنَةً وَلَا نَوْ, that Allah does not require to have some rest, to even close his eyes or to sleep. Allah Almighty, the eternal, as-samad, the one who is everything is standing upon him, or Allah Almighty is holding everything, the control of everything, and he does not need anything. This is what it means. Allahu Samad. He is Samad. Allah Almighty, he is the one who is standing and holding everything, and everything is depending on Allah Almighty, and he is independent. Can you imagine? Can you imagine that? Allahu Akbar. So when we read it next time and we say Allahu Samad, we start thinking about His Majesty Allah Almighty. And then Allah Almighty says, لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. He neither begets nor he is born. So he didn't come from anything, because anything, if it's born, it means it will end one day. So Allah, there is no beginning of Allah, there is no ending of Allah. Allah didn't give birth to anyone, neither anyone give birth to Allah Almighty. So Allah, he is the eternal, as-samad, the one who is by himself. He was there before everything, and he will be there before everything or after everything. So, لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. Not like other people, as they are claiming that Allah is having a son or a children or a wife, or the angels are the daughters of Allah. أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ. We don't believe in all that. Allah is the only one who is the eternal, who does not require anything. He does not have any children. He didn't give birth to anyone, neither anyone gave birth to him. Allah is the one, the only being, the creator, Allah Almighty. And then what? Allah Almighty said, وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. And there is nothing like him at all. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. Nor there is anything to him, or there is nothing equivalent to him. He is the unique Allah Almighty. So, if anyone's after these three or four verses, after that, whoever claims that he is God, we will tell him, come, you claiming to be God? Let's put you in the test. Are you the only one? If he is a human being and he's saying, I'm the God, are you only the one? No, there are people before you and there are people after you. So the first ayah, the first chapter or the first verse is not fitting you, so you cannot be the God. Let's go to the second verse. Allah says, Allahu Samad. Allah is controlling over everything, and he does not require to sleep, he does not require to eat, and he does not require to do anything. Do you require that? You require to sleep, you eat, you have rest, you are not having control of anything. Allah is controlling everything. So even the second test, which is the second verse, is not fitting you. The third one, لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. We will tell this person, you was born, Allah is never born. You will die, but Allah will never die. You will produce children later on in future, but Allah will never ever produce children. Allah will not give birth to anyone. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ. And there is nothing like him. Not even a single thing that you can think about that, you know, can fit to Allah Almighty. He is completely unique and you are not unique. So all these four ayat, four verses is not suiting him. It is X on him. You just put cross on this person and he cannot be the God. Now either he's a human being or a fire or a stone or whatsoever, Allah, he is the one who deserves to be worshipped. Alhamdulillah, by that we are end. We came to the end of this chapter. I ask Allah Almighty to bless us all, and I ask Allah Almighty to make us among those who worship Him alone. And inshaAllah ta'ala, we'll see you in the next episode. So stay tuned, take care of yourself. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.